Hi, my name is Dylan Sperber, and for my senior project, I decided to do an EMT class in Moscow. Unfortunately, we weren't able to have our regular open house this year, so I'm going to go ahead and take you on a quick tour of our ambulance. All right, so right here in this compartment, we have all of our main bags that we'll take on all of our calls. So here is our regular medical bag. Right here is our oxygen bag, and this is our bag for pediatric calls. Right here, this is a biohazard container for sharps and any other biohazards. Up above, we have extra sheets, extra towels, anything that we might need. All right, so right here, if you look off to the left, this is where our oxygen comes from. I'll show you the oxygen bottle later. This is where the patient obviously sits. It's our stretcher. Up in these compartments, there's all sorts of supplies. In here we have some airway supplies and IV supplies. Same thing with this one, we have some airway supplies here and some CPR masks here. In here is usually oxygen masks, but now it's mostly full of COVID-19 masks that we're using now especially. If we move on a little bit here, this is our cardiac monitor and defibrillator. So we'll put this on all of our patients. It can check heart rhythms if we put a 12-lead EKG on, and it can also shock a person who's in cardiac arrest, as well as check their blood pressure and other vitals, so it's really handy. If we move on a little further, up above, this is it's called a C-collar. It's for patients with possible spinal injuries. There's a lot of other stuff in this compartment, extra towels, things like that. Down here, we have this is a vacuum split for any broken extremities. Right here is a pelvic sling, which is basically a splint for the pelvis. Some extra towels. Down here is a burn kit, as well as some extra PPE, which is personal protective equipment, for COVID-19 related calls. Right here is a couple extra batteries for the stretcher, just in case we need them when we're out on a call. You go ahead and come outside, I'll show you the outside. So right here's actually the same compartment that you can see on the inside. It's just a different angle from it. Right here, this is called a stair chair. It just helps to move patients downstairs. In here, it's the same burn kit you saw before. These are called spider straps. They go with our backboards for spinal immobilization. I'll show you that later. Some bleeding control kits up top. Another splint. So if you come around the other side. So on this side, we have our backboards that I mentioned before. We have three of those and a stretcher. Up above, we have some chocks that hold a person's head in place for spinal immobilization. Right here we have some more immobilization devices, some more head chocks, straps, but we just make sure to have extra in case we need them.
Hello everyone, for my senior project, I made an at-home workout plan for the ladies that work out at the senior center. My plan includes stretches, four different workouts, and then a yoga exercise at the end. And so today I'm going to be going through a couple of the workouts. One, I'm going to be doing a chair squat for workout one. I'll be doing some bicep curls from workout two. I'll also be doing rock the boat from workout three. And then I'm going to do tree pose from the yoga workout. So let's get started.
Just
So although these workouts may seem easy, they're actually harder when you're older. And I made sure all of these workouts were approved. So I looked them up and I found them on sources that were reliable, that were made by physical therapists or by health clinics. So I hope you guys enjoyed my open house presentation and I hope you enjoy my project. Thanks for watching.
Hi guys, I'm Kyra Sarnworth and my senior project is Mr. GHS, as you can see right here. And if you don't know what that is, it's kind of a spoof on a talent show where senior boys get on stage and try to be funny, but definitely make a fool of themselves. I planned the whole entire thing from writing commentary and creating choreography to collecting donations, including flex tape, and making thank yous for those donations. And unfortunately, I'm unable to have the actual event because of coronavirus. So as a substitute, I created kind of a fun and interactive Instagram post that you can answer what talent you're most excited to see, guess who's wearing a dress, and then see a little bit about the boys and learn what their talents were going to be if we would have been able to have it. Tender love is blind. It requires a dedication. My dad wore when he won Mr. GHS in 1997, and this is the crown and sash I got for the 2020 winner. Making love with each other, islands in the stream, that is what we are.
Welcome to my virtual open house of my senior project. Now here in my hand is literally my senior project that I did called Claire's Family Cookbook. And on the front, you can see that this is actually a senior photo that someone took for me. So not only is there senior photos in here, there's only two in here actually, but there are actually family photos in here since it's a family cookbook. So it's really nice to have family in here, especially I have members of my family who have passed, so I even have pictures of them in here. So I'm just going to get right into it. So we have the opening title of Claire's Family Cookbook, and that is a senior photo of me right there. Next, we have the table of contents, which I will briefly read to you real fast. So the sections we have are miscellaneous, dessert, sauces, main dish, breakfast, salads, appetizers, and beverages, Instapot, breads, side dish, and soups. And we have 3 pages of the table of contents. And of course, we have a dedication page because all of this was mainly dedicated to my family since they were able to send recipes to me, which was really nice because I could add them in and now I have something to look back in, even with the photos. And even if I go to college or have my own house, I can take this with me. So I really dedicate their time for them to send me recipes so I could put this in. And then after that, it just goes right into it. So we have like miscellaneous, here's a picture of my grandparents. And then literally like after that, there's like loaded of approximately 200 recipes in this book. This is what I did for my senior project was my cookbook, as I mentioned earlier. And I just want to thank you for coming to my virtual open house. Thank you.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm going to be telling you guys a little bit about my project and then showing you how to get to the website so that you can go and take a look at it yourself. So for my project, I made a add-on to the school's website, which is a valedictorian webpage. On the webpage, it has most all valedictorians from 1959 to present. And I faced a couple challenges with this, but luckily for me, and with Corona going on, I was still able to finish this project in mostly the original manner. Originally, when I was going to make this project, I was going to add on a description for all of the valedictorians, but due to time constraints, I was unable to complete that. So it's just their picture, their name, and their graduation year. So to get to the website, you go to sd282.org, Then you go to district information under the, and then go to alumni. And then under the alumni tab, there is valedictorians. So you go to the valedictorians, and then it will show you all the valedictorians, so you can go and take a look through that. And I hope that you guys enjoy my project.
Hi, everybody. So for my senior project, I did an online suture clinic, and I'm just going to show everybody just a small part of what I taught at the clinic. All right, so what I'm going to be showing today is called a simple surgeon's knot. So I have my suture held 2/3 of the way back on the suture. So you go in at a 50 degree angle and you twist your hand. Make sure it's as even as possible on both sides. And you get it so there's a little bit of hang on the suture. And you wrap your suture around your needle drivers twice. You grab the edge and you pull down. And then you always want to keep your needle drivers in the middle of the suture stitch. So you wrap around once again, you grab it, and you pull. And then you use your scissors to cut off the ends and make it look pretty. So here we have our simple surgeon's knot.
And welcome to part one of how to prepare for high school choir. Junior high and high school choir can actually be quite different, even though they share many similarities. One huge difference is the amount of difficulty in the pieces that you'll be singing and the parts. For instance, junior high songs might only have 2 or 3 parts, whereas in high school there are usually at least 4. Now, this might seem like a difficult task, especially if you're in a small choir. But don't worry, because your director will be very helpful, as well as the older members of your section who know what they're doing. Now, in high school, there are generally 4 different parts that you sing. If you're a girl, you will sing soprano or alto. Sopranos sing higher, altos sing lower. And if you're a boy, you'll sing tenor or bass. Tenors sing higher, and basses sing lower. To get a good understanding of your vocal range, there are actually several videos on YouTube that can help you. They usually have a piano, and they play the notes, and then you sing the part, and they tell you if your range is from a certain place to another certain place, then you fit in with a specific part. A lot of the time in choir classes, your teacher will voice you, which means that they will bring you next to a piano, and they will play the notes for you and have you sing a certain amount, and the notes that you sing and your comfortability with them will determine how wide your range is and where you can sing in class. It's okay if your range isn't super wide, because you don't need a super huge vocal range to be a good singer. It's also worth noting that the part that you're placed in your freshman year is probably not where you're going to stay, so don't worry if you don't want to be an alto or if you don't want to be a tenor, because at this age your voices are still changing. In fact, our voices don't stop changing until we're almost 30, so it's important to remember that where we are today might not be where we are tomorrow, and we might not be able to sing notes tomorrow that we were able to sing today. But understanding your voice part should help you have a firm grasp on what to do when you first start in choir. Another potentially scary part about high school choir is the level of difficulty in the new pieces that you'll be singing. If you're an alto or tenor, you'll most likely be singing a harmony. A harmony, if you don't know what that means, is basically a collection of notes that fit in within the chord that you're singing, but they're different from the melody. They're usually meant to complement the notes that the sopranos and the basses are singing. Not necessarily the main part, but a lot of the time the harmonies will actually be the ones that are supposed to be in the forefront. Now, the voice part that you determine when you test yourself might not be the one that you'll be actually singing in choir, but that's okay. Have a firm grasp of what you can do and how your range performs, then you should be fine. I hope this video is informative, and I will see you guys in the next one.
Hey, my name is Dakota. The purpose, so pretty much here's a brief description. There's not really a title to it or anything, but this is the FFA website I have built. So, picture of me, of course, built the website. So pretty much why I made this website is because, I mean, I've always enjoyed making projects out in the shop with Mr. Morrow. It's something I've really enjoyed. But anyway, so I just wanted to do something pretty much for the whole school to see, the community. So here's the 19th. So I pretty much went through every decade in these scrapbooks I found out in the shop. And I gotta say, they're pretty scattered throughout the shop. I mean, it's hard to find them, but I mean, the scanning part as well as posting it on the website and pretty much making all these tabs and stuff. I mean, that was also a pain, but it was also worth the while. I mean, it helps me graduate and benefits me in the future, then I'll definitely take it. And I mean, pretty much these are all the decades, 1970s through 1980s, 1990s, and also we have 2000s, and we got the 2010s, which in the pictures, you can see that the colors, like, they eventually change. Like, here's, like, 1990s, for example, compared to the 1980s. As you can see, 1980s is pretty much where color still yellowish, orangish kind of stuff, but you know, I guess 1990s is pretty much where it started to progress. Anyway, this is my website. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Kendra, and my senior project was teaching the 8th graders all about nutrition. I created a set of 5 assignments that were supposed to be interesting, yet challenging for the 8th graders to learn from. Originally, I was supposed to teach in the classroom, but unfortunately, due to the circumstances that we're in right now, I wasn't able to teach in the classroom, but I was still able to convert my lessons to online learning. From keeping track of their meals to conducting a scavenger hunt in their own house to find a protein, dairy, and grain item, each student learned quite a bit from these lessons. Even though I got the chance to communicate with the students via email, it wasn't quite the same as the classroom learning would have been. This project helped me share my love for nutrition while also getting a feel for potentially becoming a teacher later on.
Lace up, surround gel, stabilizing, callousy, hinged, double strapped, sport, surround foam, surround air. These are all ankle splints. And if you need a splint, you might need your blood pressure taken, pulse and O2 measured, and other vital signs because you're at the doctor's office and I can help you with that. For my senior project, I volunteered for the Palouse Free Clinic where I did 2 projects for them. I organized splints and I put them into a spreadsheet and I made videos teaching volunteers how to take vital signs. I organized hundreds of splints and put them into boxes, putting them in a spreadsheet, and they went from looking like this. These were in my basement, and the other picture is the transportation of the splints in my car, to this, where they are organized by body part and they correspond with the spreadsheet that I mentioned. They have the size, the side, what container they're in, and any extra notes about the splints. The other product I did was vital signs, and here is the intro that I used for both videos.
Vital signs are extremely important in diagnosing a patient. They help dictate the treatment, they help show if a patient is deteriorating or improving, and they help medical care workers make decisions. High-quality vital signs that improve the life of a patient are something to be proud of, and that is why, over the course of two videos, I'm going to teach you about them.
I showed the volunteers how to take vital signs, like in this video, this is blood pressure.
So the cuff is 2 inches above. We find the artery with the stethoscope, and we want to listen to it. And would you hold this so I can see? Perfect, thank you. And with one hand, I'm going to be holding down the stethoscope, and the other, I'm going to be tightening the bulb. So, and then I'm going to pump it up to about 180, or you can do 200 if you want.
Also talked about
the next vital sign let's talk about is oxygen saturation. Technically, it's not a vital sign, but it does help you check to see if a patient is dealing with respiratory problems or if they don't have enough oxygen in their blood, which is also considered hypoxia. A patient should have between 95 and 100 in their blood.
And then I go on about the different measurements that hypoxia can have in patients. I also talked about the tools necessary in the videos. And in these videos, I learned a ton about medical research, organizing medical supplies, and producing and editing videos. And these are all things that I can use in my future career. And this only took me about 94 total hours with the help of a few people documenting the splints. Thank you so much for watching.
So for my senior project 2020, I decided originally to add an accessible entrance feature for anybody who needs it. I wanted to add a handicap push button outside of the gym foyer because it was a door that was continuously used throughout the year, and I thought it was something we could really use and value. But I decided to change my project due to the coronavirus, and because of the coronavirus, I had a short amount of time, so I decided to change my project to a tumor analysis, which is the evolution of gameplay design for the role of the female protagonist. During this, some of the challenges I had was just the coronavirus, like I said, time management, and some fine-tuning towards the end. So an overlook of my book, this is the cover, and then throughout the table of contents just kind of just shows what I go over, what games I played. Through my project, I really just played three of the games. I played about 3 to 4 hours of each game. And using what I learned and some further research, I was able to break down each game into make an analysis of the resolution of each game, controls, puzzles, difficulty. I do this for each game. I played the first Tomb Raider, the Tomb Raider Angel of Darkness in 2003 as seen. And then I also play the newest game in 2018 called Tomb Raider Shadow of the Tomb Raider. Along with that, I also talk a little bit about the game timeline. And then I also go into a woman's role in gaming and how Tomb Raider kind of changed the industry and turned it around. So I talk about how Lara was an empowering character, and I also talk about how her body changed over time and how the world kind of went about that. Again, there's just a summary at the end and then my sites, and that is it. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Skylar Tucker, and I'm here to show you why you should wear Papa Tux when you skate.
Oh, cut!
Now that was just silly. Let me show you how you skate better with Papa Tux. Feel better, look better, skate better. Papa Tux. This is my senior project open house video. This is my senior project. It is a therapeutic sensory room located in the special education room on the elementary side of the school building. The room was donated to be my Mrs. Castro, the elementary special education teacher. I decided to do a therapeutic sensory room for my senior project because we didn't have one, and I thought that there was a need for one. So just getting started, the first thing we did in here was paint the walls. The paint was called concrete. It's a nice calming color. As well, we have some different seating options here to my left, different sized exercise balls which different students could sit on. Right here is what's called a pea pod. It's essentially an air bean bag that compresses the person that sits inside it, so it acts as a hug, and it's very calming for students with developmental disabilities. Here to my right, we have a crash pad, which is it's essentially what a gymnast does flips onto. It's nice, soft foam with a velvety cover. Right here, as you enter the room, on the left, there is a shelving unit that houses all of the different stimuli that will be in the room. So right here on the top, we have a LED projector that projects a light similar to what the ocean looks like at night. It's very calming and it's cool to look at. Right over here, we bought a slide dimmer to dim the lights in here. Currently, we have LED lights in the ceiling, but we just need to install this. And then lastly, on the top of the shelf, we have a couple different snacks. They're just granola minis that'll be here for the kids to eat. And then getting on to what's in the shelves, first of all, up here, we have some hand exercise putty, which is very calming, fun to play with, and we have four different colors. Moving on, this is our hot and cold therapy drawer. First off, we have hot and cold massage balls, which you roll around your skin like that. You warm them up by placing them in warm hot water in a Pyrex glass like so, and you massage yourself with them. Right here, these green things are hot and cold massage wraps, and lastly, this is a hot cold eye mask. Moving on, right here we have two different colors of magic sand. It's also a very cool texture. As you can tell, everything is about texture in this room. Because it is sensory, as well as it's housed in a glass container, which gives it a little extra weight, so that's also nice touch. In the shelf below it, we just have some repair equipment for the exercise ball as well as the pea pod. And then right here in this drawer, we have a dermatology tool. It's just very, very calming, very smooth sensation that you can get on your rub on your face, and then we also have a sponge just for texture. The shelf below it, we have a 15-pound weighted blanket and a 7-pound weighted stuffed animal. Lastly, we have our two buckets of balls. They just vary in texture characteristics. So we have two different types of balls. And that is my senior project open house video. Thank you for watching.
My name is Reagan Zenner, and for my senior project, I was the U14 varnish volleyball assistant coach. Volleyball has always been my favorite sport, so I knew that through this project, I wanted to help younger athletes develop their skills since I have been in their same situation. For this season and project, I came up with 7 measurable goals for the girls this season, all about footwork and ball control. To give you some insight on what my project looked like, I took some videos of the drills we often did at practice and our progression through the season. hope you all enjoyed getting a small preview of my senior project. If you are still trying to come up with an idea for your senior project, I would highly recommend pushing yourself out of your comfort zone to coach something that you're passionate about in some way. I was able to learn a lot about myself and gain many valuable tools that I can use in the future.
Hello everyone, my name is Makaysha Bartos, and for my senior project, I decided to make care packages for all of the kids at the Northwest Children's Home. And so I'm just going to take you through some of the steps of my project and then also outline some of the changes I made due to COVID-19. So my first step was to design a wish list, so the kids could fill them out and I can get a better idea of some of the things that they wanted in their care packages, and also to be able to design each of their personalized pillowcases, which I would be making for them. And then my second step after receiving all of the care package wish lists back from the kids was to go ahead and start making their personalized pillowcases. And for the design, I tried to make the cuff a pattern that they really liked, or just one of the interests that they were into. And then I tried to make the body of the pillowcase their favorite color. And here is an example of a pillowcase that I made. And then after I was finished making all the pillowcases for the kids, I moved on to reaching out to different local businesses and trying to collect sponsors for my project so that I could fill each of the care packages with multiple goodies. And then I ended up receiving a generous donation from our local business here in town, P&W, and I also received one from Sylvan Furniture. So thank you guys so much. After I collect the donations for my project, my next step was to go out and collect all of the goodies that would go inside of the care packages and the contents, really, of the care packages. And after I was finished collecting all of the contents of the care packages, it was time to assemble all of them and make sure they were all tidy and ready to be delivered to Brian Pope, who's the executive director of the Northwest Children's Home. And from there, he delivered them to all the kids at the Northwest Children's Home. And now, some of the changes that I made due to COVID-19 with my project. The first one I made, I had originally planned to make care packages for all of the kids at the Northwest Children's Home. But after the COVID-19 restrictions sort of came to life, the educational group of kids no longer came to school, which made it really hard to get the results back from their wish list and also to deliver the care packages to them after they were finished. And so I decided to just make the care packages for the residential side of the Northwest Children's Home. And then the second decision I made as far as changes went is to only give the kids cash to spend on something they wanted rather than filling their care packages with a bunch of goodies, just because a lot of the stores were closed during these times, and so I felt that it would be a lot easier to give them each cash, and I also figured that they would want to have spending money so they could get the thing that they really wanted most. Thank you for listening.
I'm Julian, CEO of Incongruity LLC and the inventor of the Zerpo Land Anchor. We're out here trying to get a side-by-side stuck so we can test it out.
My name is Claire Smith, and my senior project was designing logos for the Genesee School District. Now, when I first started this project, it was a little hard, but in the end, I came up with some great designs. The purpose was to give the district an iconic and original logo, and also to give them a logo where they didn't have to worry about copyright laws, since we use Gonzaga's Bulldogs for some things. I just wanted to give them something so that we didn't have to worry about that. And I did the project to help out the community and not help out just myself. And when I did this project, I split it up into three main different parts: elementary, high school, and the faculty and staff. When I first got started, I started off with these rough drafts, and these rough drafts became into the 9 logos that I did for each of the individual parts of the school, which was elementary, high school, and faculty and staff.
Hi everyone, this is my open house for my senior project. My senior project was on picking up garbage alongside the highways and the roads and campsites. I think my senior project went really well besides what happened with the coronavirus. I spent around 57 hours total with the journal and the presentation included, and about 19 of those hours were picking up garbage. I kind of enjoyed it, but it's hard to enjoy picking up garbage around the highway, and I think it would have been a better experience if I went to different campsites and walked around in the woods. But due to the coronavirus, I just stayed around the highway where most garbage goes anyways, instead of going to the campsites because all of them were closed. I really enjoyed walking around and seeing how much garbage there really is. It was a good feeling knowing that I picked up it and that at least helped a little bit. Most of the garbage I picked up was plastic and cardboard boxes. And probably the weirdest thing that I ever picked up was a bunch of photos of people going fishing and camping and going to zoos, and like a whole bunch of baby photos that someone probably accidentally dropped out of their car without knowing. I'm also thinking about cleaning up garbage in the future, especially around campsites, because that's where most of my career will be. And I want to become a fish and game officer so I can help animals bring back the environment without it being followed with garbage. I think everyone should at least pick up a little bit of garbage sometime in their life, because everybody has a good chance that they've littered before. And so that's pretty much it for my senior project. Thank you for listening.
I'm a greaser, and for my senior project, I decided to do a cheer camp. My cheer camp was on March 14th from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. for 1st through 6th grade. The first thing I did to plan my cheer camp was create the flyers and the sign-up sheets. I had to go around and give all the teachers enough sign-up sheets for all of their students and give them a flyer for their classroom and put flyers up around the school. The next thing I did was create an outline for my day. We started with like a check-in time, then moved on to warm-ups, and then did basic moves, and then moved on to cheers and dances, and then we made bows. And then after lunch, we did tumbling, stunting, and then we played a few games, and we had a snack time, and then we learned a routine that we would perform for our parents at the end of the day. In total, this project took me 31 hours, and it cost me $107 for the bows and all the things to decorate the bows with, but this project was really fun, and I'm really happy I did it.
Hi, I'm Laura Craig, and for my senior project, I was originally planning on doing a donation for the YWCA. The donation was supposed to involve food, baby supplies, cleaning supplies, basically anything that the YWCA needed, or their members needed. I was planning on hosting this donation at the YWCA on Main Street in Lewiston, but this was, however, forced to go off course due to the coronavirus. So instead I had to change my project into doing just like a clothing donation. So basically what I did was I just went to people's houses that I knew and I asked them if they wanted to donate, and if they did, then they did, and if they didn't, they didn't. So I got around 15 bags of clothing. After I obtained all these bags of clothing when I was done with my senior project, I donated them to the St. Vincent de Paul in Clarkston, where YWCA members can shop for free. Altogether, I got like a lot of baby clothes and a lot of women and children clothes, which like really helped because that's what they mainly needed. So I spent about 54 hours on my senior project, and I don't have a cost estimate of like how much gas that I used, but I definitely drive to a couple of places. You know, I had to drive to Mason and to Genesee and to Moscow. So yeah, thank you guys for listening.
All right, for my senior project, I built this rocking chair and a side table to go with it. It took me about 40 hours to make the two things combined, and it took me about 10 more hours to do all my presentation and paper and all that thing. So really, I just made this out of maple wood and walnut. My biggest challenge was making the joints right here to hold the legs and the armrests together well. I had to make them really strong, and it took a little bit of trial and error. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It cost me about $250 to make, and I've got a few offers to from people who want to buy it, and so I'm thinking about making another one and selling it. But yeah, that's the chair I made.
Everyone goes down a happy path, and out of the blue, something gray and huge blocks your path. A challenge that is huge, stressful, and frightening. You fear losing great and wonderful things, like baseball, your last prom, and a traditional graduation. But you got friends and family to help you along in rough times. With a goal in mind to conquer, by striving for your goal, you have nothing to lose. Achieving goals makes you stronger, so you can smile in the face of fear and make fear fear you.
Hello, I'm Tanner Gray. This is my senior project. So here I did building my mini bass boat. So what we got here is my 12-foot Bass Tracker Tadpole John boat. So originally what I'm standing on here is the original floor that the original owner had in it, or he installed, and he also installed this battery box. So that's basically just my dry box, so I got like paperwork and whatnot in there, and then my battery. So what I did is this whole deck up to there, there, and back is what I built and carpeted, and then I added on this Minn Kota trolling motor with the foot control on it. So what I was really looking for is something that I can haul all, or most of, if not all, my gear. So I got a decent amount of tackling here, not all of it, on this side. And then on this side over here, I have a few boxes taken out, but rain gear, scale, and some rope in there for just taking off. And then up here, I added this rod buckle, maybe, there we go, this rod buckle there, so you can strap your rod down while you're going down the road. And then this trolling motor here just sometimes likes to go, maybe not. Okay, well, the point is, this sits up and drops down in the water, and then this is your foot control here, so you can steer left and right and whatnot. So that is my senior project.
For my senior project, I chose to take this horse here and turn her into a barrel horse. It was a really long, really difficult project, but it's been so worth it, and I'm so excited with where we are. Through the project, we took the horse that ran like this. This is an ongoing project, so I'm not going to be done now that school's out or that my project is technically over with. We're going to keep doing it. I'm going to keep getting her to be faster and tighter and better, and we're going to keep competing and entering to go compete on the University of Arizona rodeo team this fall. There were a lot of challenges with this project between COVID and the fact that she does have a mind of her own and does have feelings, and sometimes she just has a bad day, as do I. I'm so happy of all the challenges we've overcome and how hard we've both worked to get to where we are now. This is something that, like I said, I definitely am not going to stop doing now, and it's not just over with now that the project is, but the project definitely really helped me to get it together and get a timeline and really held me to it, so that we've made a lot of progress to be where we are now. So all summer, and like I said, through college rodeo, we will still be at it, and now I have a horse who can do that for me.
Hey guys, I'm Grace Freewood, and for my senior project, I did my nature photography book, so I'm going to go through it. So the first page shows three different pictures where we go camping, which is in Bowville. Here are two different types of pictures that are in Genesee home, and there's a song lyric that I felt represented home, which the song lyric reads, "Home, a place where I can go to take this off my shoulders, someone take me home." And so on the third page, there's again different pictures of at Genesee. This is at the football field. This one's also at the football field. And that one. The other two are on the back of my, in the backyard of my house. So for this one, it's a blowed up picture. And show them. One big picture, another big one picture, and so with this page, it's just to Lewiston. And with this one, back to home. So this is back to Genesee, and these are all like where I walked to school or used to walk to school. This is a blown-up picture of Cow Creek. And also, at back to home. Just random home pictures. And this is my final picture. My final blown up picture of it. And then at the very end, Arlie. And the day I worked on it, picture of me and my brothers, and a little description of me and my photography. And that is my senior project.
Is this thing on? Is it working? I'm not really sure how this is supposed to work, but...
Gandalf, we can all see and hear you. Just sit back and look at the screen.
Oh, okay. Well, everyone, welcome to the annual fellowship meeting. I know that we usually meet at Rivendell, but due to circumstances right now, we are unable to meet in person. However, thanks to my amazing wizarding skills... we are still able to meet.
It's called Zoom, and you had nothing to do with it.
No matter. It looks like everyone is present. Wait, where is Sam?
Oh, sorry, Gandalf, I'm right here. I thought I'd get some gardening in while I logged on. How does it look?
It looks beautiful, Sam.
You really mean that, Mr. Frodo?
Yes, it looks great. But you need to go home, Sam.
You don't mean that.
No. All I meant was you need to go inside. Your connection's bad.
So, how is everyone doing with this quarantine thing going on?
Well, I've been very
busy. I have.
You go.
No, you were speaking first. You go.
Well, I've been very busy. I've just reached 1,000 subscribers to my gaming channel.
Oh, please. I have over 1 million subscribers to my channel.
Speaking of which, I loved your last video, Legolas. Your trick shots are always the best.
That was nothing. Just wait for my next one.
What about my video? I got like 15 kills.
I probably would have gotten 16.
I'd like to see you try.
Stop this nonsense at once. We have more important matters to discuss.
Oh no, Gandalf. Is something wrong?
No. Quite to the contrary, actually. I have some very exciting news.
Could we speed this up a bit? I have an Instagram Live soon, and I need to prepare.
I have decided it is time we go on another quest.
What? I do not have the time for that. Not at all.
Yeah, I can see that.
I can't either. I have to post every day. And what if there is no Wi-Fi wherever we are questing?
What is the reason we have to go on a quest?
Well, I was thinking that we could toss another ring into a volcano.
I don't think that's a good idea, Gandalf. Last time, we barely made it out alive. Mr. Frodo and I mean.
Oh, right. Well, we could clean out Moria. We kind of left that place in shambles.
No, that place is best left how it is.
Sounds more like community service than a quest.
Well... I don't know. Maybe we could go to Walmart and... I hear they have good deals on toilet paper. I could call the Giant Eagles! I haven't had an excuse to use them lately.
Gandalf, are you lonely?
No. Well, maybe a little bit. Ever since this quarantine started, I've missed my friends. There's only so much firework making one person can do.
Don't worry, Gandalf. We can all help you. After all, we are your friends.
Yes, Mr. Frodo's right. In fact, I'll send you over a nice plump turnip to cheer you up.
Thank you, Sam.
You could be in one of my videos. My followers would love that.
I suppose you could watch me play.
Yes, and feel free to call me at any time.
Thank you. Thank you all. This really has brightened up my spirits. I will definitely... Hang on a second. Well, it was very nice talking to you all. I hope you have a fantastic week.
Why are you going so soon, Gandalf? We barely just started.
Oh, no reason. I just remembered I left my fireworks shed unlocked.
Yeah, right. We all know Galadriel is calling. Good luck, Gandalf.
I'll send my turnip tomorrow.
I better get back to my very important duties. Oh, of course, I can bring the eagles by any time. Whatever you like. Oh, bother, I left this.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Sager. The picture here shown is a picture of a wiener dog Yorkie mix, and her name is Zoe. Today, she was my little model, just to help show off how my project would be used. For my senior project, I made 3 small, medium, and large beds and blankets to donate to the local animal shelters. And Zoe here was actually adopted from a pound just about a year ago. For my senior project, I chose to relate it to the career that I want to go into. Some struggles that occurred while making all of the beds and blankets, the fabric that I had bought was stretchy one direction and non-stretchy the other. So when cutting it, it would shrink, throwing off all my measurements. And tying it, especially when I had to tie both of the non-stretchy sides, I would have to redo them, and it was just very hard. Doing that over and over made my hands hurt. So I spent 46 hours on my project, and I started in the middle of February. And I started with the blankets just so I can get the motion and get the knots down. Then I moved on to the cases. And for the cases, I had to sew. So I thought that it was going to be so difficult, but it actually wasn't once I got the hang of all the buttons on the sewing machine. The only difficult part was keeping the speed steady and also keeping it in a straight line. And other than that, I really enjoyed my project. While making my project, I was able to spend a lot more time with my grandma, who was also my mentor. And because of this project, I was able to give back to all the animal shelters that do so much for the animals that they have. And I just wanted to give those animals just a little bit more love and comfort and make them feel just a little more at home. So I really hope that all of you guys enjoyed this and listening to me just talk about my project. I know that this project may seem so simple and bland, but it can really inspire you to do something good for the communities around you. And it made me feel such a sense of pride and enjoyment. And I know that it can do that for so many others. So thank you all for just sitting here and listening to me. And I really hope that you guys all have such a good day.